week on Storyboard, on the heels of the success of the first season of Netflix Sacred Games, we find out how OTT platforms such as Netflix, Amazon Prime and Hotstar are giving traditional television a tough fight. We caught up with John Bain, Vice President and General Manager, Corning Gorilla Glass, Corning Specialty Materials, on the sideline of the launch of their Gorilla Glass 6 in Sunnyvale, California, and spoke to him about the potential of Indian smartphone market for a company like Corning and what makes Gorilla Glass so elusive. And we catch up with legendary ad man Ram Sehgal, who was conferred with this year's Triple A's of I Lifetime Achievement Award this week. Hello and welcome to Storyboard. This is Shivani Gharat. Low quality regressive content on television, high penetration of smartphones in the country and low mobile data tariff after Reliance Jio splash into the telecom sector. The convergence of these three factors has seen Indian viewers hopping on to the OTT platforms such as Netflix, Amazon Prime and Hotstar in search of high quality video content that can be viewed on demand. With the number of OTT video users in India set to touch 355 million by 2020, the stage is set for OTTs to tap into a 5,600 crore rupees opportunity. But what will it take for OTTs to get there? Storyboard's Farah Bookwala Vora finds out, and she says that the answer lies in two words: going local. Let's take a look at the full story.
लाइफ बदलने वाला है तुम्हारा 25 दिन है बचा लेना अपने शहर को
डार्क विसरल एक्सप्लोसिव
यही तो खूबसूरती है इस शहर की साहिब
सेट अगेंस्ट द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ मुंबईज अंडरवर्ल्ड नेटफ्लिक्स न्यूएस्ट ओरिजिनल सीक्रेट गेम्स हैज पुट द स्पॉटलाइट ऑन द पावर ऑफ गुड स्टोरी टेलिंग डायरेक्टेड बाय अनुराग कश्यप एंड विक्रम आदित्य मोतवाने सीक्रेट गेम्स इज बीइंग हेल्ड फॉर ब्रेकिंग बैरियर्स as it unfolds a dangerous cat-and-mouse game between a fugitive mafia kingpin, played by Nawazuddin Siddiqui, and a troubled police officer, portrayed by Saif Ali Khan, in an 8-episode-long series. Sacred Games' opening to rave reviews tells us two things. One, viewers in India are hungry for strong, differentiated content. Two, while the bouquet of licensed TV catch-up shows, from Game of Thrones to Narcos to Breaking Bad, is a big draw for India's English-speaking urban youth, the universe of non-English users in search of good content is much larger. This is the opportunity OTT platforms including Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, Alt Balaji and Voot are looking to cash in on by producing quality local original content. Across the 30-odd OTTs in India, a significant 2,500 to 3,300 crore rupees has been committed to creating original content over 3 to 5 years, with Amazon Prime Video committing the largest stake through an investment of 2,000 crore rupees.
We understand the importance of being locally relevant. We have stepped rather ambitiously into not just local content, but into local originals as well. The high concept stories, gritty dramas, you know, character-based thrillers. These are all stories that customers are waiting to not only consume, but also comment and share.
We need to raise an army now.
That brings us to the question. What is the size of the opportunity OTTs are chasing? The answer, a substantial 5,600 crore rupees. According to PwC India, the OTT segment is currently worth $400 million, or 2,760 crore rupees, and it is growing at a compounded annual growth rate of 22.6%. Aided largely by local original content, India will be among the 10th largest OTT markets by revenues by 2022, accounting for revenues of $823 million or 5,600 crore rupees. Regional content, which presently accounts for 40% of the viewership on OTTs, will provide a huge push as the base of vernacular users grows 2.5 times that of English users by 2021. That's why OTT players are stepping on the gas to churn out high quality Hindi and regional language shows.
India is not a English speaking urban market. It's largely Hindi and non-English speaking languages, right? In fact, we quite believe in this thesis of the wide chasm between Nagin and Narcos, right? So Narcos, which is urban India niche, will be about 100 million potential, whereas 900 million people who consume entertainment in Hindi and other languages are the mainstays, and that's where our focus remains.
I feel that it's a very underserved market right now, extremely underserved, which can only mean good things because there is that much space to create for them. We are working overtime to create a slew of big scale, long format originals, both in Hindi as well as in all our languages that we play across the network.
After Sacred Games, Netflix will bring three new Indian originals, with its horror series Ghaul releasing on August 24th. Netflix has outlined around $8 billion for content worldwide for 2018, and India, its fastest growing market, will receive a lion's share of that. Viu, which launched 9 originals this year, is launching 20 more by the year, and it will enter the Tamil market with 6. Sony Live, which has Marathi and Gujarati web series, now plans to enter into regional short films. Z5 offers 7 original web series, 3 Hindi short films and regional web series in Telugu, Tamil and Malayalam. By March 2019, Z5 aims to host over 90 plus original shows. The flush of local original content on OTTs is expected to significantly drive up subscriber numbers in a market that is seeing a 100% jump annually. Currently, Hotstar has the highest number of monthly active subscribers, while Netflix has the least. OTT revenue models vary greatly. For Netflix and Alt Balaji, paid subscribers are the sole revenue stream, while for Voot, advertising drives its revenues. Hotstar and Sony Live follow hybrid revenue models. While ad-free platforms may be a feature today, the dependence on advertising for revenues will only grow in the future. Deloitte's report says the digital advertising market is expected to nearly double to 354 billion rupees by 2020, cannibalizing revenues from TV, radio and print.
I don't think too much of subscription is going to go to all the OTT platforms. I mean, some of them like Netflix might, because in India, the consumer is not used to paying for content in that sense. So therefore, their reliance on advertising will actually increase as time goes.
While advertising may not be on the cards yet for some, brand integrations as a way to monetize the platform have begun.
Opportunities that therefore, you know, get created can get created looking at the content that they bring on board, and they could be, you know, full-fledged in the sense that you devise content, devise a full show or a full series based on what a brand requires, or it could be, you know, the subtle or the actual placement based on the opportunities that, you know, a show has.
The amount of data that we churn will allow brands to really figure out who is consuming that ad at what time, at which place, and at what context. That has never happened before, right? So you will increasingly see a lot of seamless brands integrations. We are in fact evaluating a technology which is called dynamic ad insertions, where you don't need to pre-ingest an ad. Right. So there are people who are now working on this technology.
While brand integrations are coming to the fore, OTTs realize that force-fitting a brand into a storyline or integrating too many brands can be a recipe for disaster.
Coffee, couches and spill beans.
For OTTs, creating local original content is not free from challenges. The first big challenge is to find and target the right audience for their content. A second big challenge is to create stories that will compel viewers to keep coming back to the platform episode after episode. And a third big challenge, surprising as it may sound, it is finding the right talent.
The biggest challenge, I would say, is talent. As a market, we are not ready to feed the demand. It's almost like it's a hungry beast, and you've got to feed the beast. So, and I'm talking about talent, writing talent, directorial talent, performing talent. The money is there. But to service the demand, you need a certain level of talent.
Talent management agencies feel it's a matter of time before the mismatch between the demand and supply of talent is bridged.
The number of platforms will condense into a select bunch of people, a select bunch of platforms who people will rely on to go back to immediately. It'll eventually break into your top 5 or 10 television channels in that format itself on OTT. And I think that's where you'll have a lot of traffic flowing. And then effectively, because it's not appointment viewing and it's purely content-based viewing, I think the better the content that comes out, you'll find more and more talent attaching themselves to it. And this is not just actors here. There's also directors, music directors, actors for sure, writers, comics, authors.
Censorship and litigation issues are also assuming importance. At present, the internet in India enjoys great freedom as it is outside the grasp of India's censor board. But with Netflix being dragged to court over sacred games featuring dialogues deemed offensive to former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, experts say the overhang of censorship could be a big spanner in a wheel that has only just caught speed.
It is time for us to slip into a short break. On the other side of this break, we catch up with John Bain, Vice President and General Manager, Corning Gorilla Glass, Corning Specialty Materials, and find out what he has to say about the new Corning Gorilla Glass 6 and why has their technology become so important for smartphone makers across the world.